patent known as John the Engineer Turmel. On the back, it's going to say the Engineer Turmel. They made me drop the John. They said, how can you prove you're known as the engineer? So I gave them Wikipedia and the Guinness Book of Records, and it worked. Now, what have I been doing during this election? Geez, I was excluded from the half a dozen meetings there have been so far. This is the only meeting to which I've been invited. And so what I did was, I've been contacting all sorts of little parties to organize them into a coalition for one great idea. Now, a lot of people know that I'm the guy who engineered the first Let's Time Bank software. And that allowed single poor parents to log on what nights they could double duty babysit each other's kids and pay each other with 1 hour bills, even when they're broke. And that way the mechanic might take 3 hours per hour because he wants babysitting, and the doctor might take 6 hours per hour. But a support network grows around poor people who have no money using the Let's software. And all it really is software to run like poker chips. Keep track of who's up and who's down. Well, we want to install this software at the Bank of Canada. You heard about quantitative easing in the UK? Jeremy Corbyn wants the Bank of England to lend the government money interest-free to finance infrastructure, like the Bank of Canada used to finance the Seaway interest-free before Pierre canceled Bank of Canada use and forced the provinces and us to go to the private banks in 1974. And since then, we have massive debts and debt service. So, Corbyn wants it. The Comer Bank of Canada case, they're asking for Bank of Canada accounts for governments. Well, I'm saying, if getting interest-free loans to pay off your interest-bearing debts, so all payments go against principal after that, is good for governments, why not people too? So this is my cartoon for this election. This election, it has the monkey with the Let software in front of the SysOp at the Bank of Canada's computer. And it says that, who are you going to vote for? The monkey with the software that's going to give you an interest-free Bank of Canada account? Or are those party leaders who don't have any software or programs to do such? And of course, I'm the organizer in the picture. So, now we've got, now what am I going to do? I've got candidates from 11 different parties on a coalition, and I've published it at my site now. I started a site, SmartestManOnEarth.ca. No one else had ever taken it in 20 years. No one else dared, except for the great Canadian gambler. So, and I took it, and there you will find the smart team. And what I did was I said, whoa, in 1988, the Greens had the Let's on their platform. But then next guys took it off. Then in 1997, the Greens signed the Canada Let's petition and then disappeared again. And in 2012, at the convention, they had a resolution for using the Bank of Canada to fund infrastructure, like Jeremy Corbyn's trying to do in the UK, and it got rejected. But there are Greens who know the potential of Let's at the Bank of Canada for governments. But I'm saying, why can't I get an account? The software can work for people too, so I can cut a check to pay off my chargebacks, a check to pay off my mortgage, my credit cards, student loans, all interest-bearing debts to the loan sharks below by borrowing from the Bank of Canada account. And after that, all my payments go against principal. And someday, I'm out of debt, and everyone else could be too. If we could just skip the middleman loan shark bank phase and go right to the top at the Bank of Canada. So, SmartestManOnEarth.ca smart team has candidates from 11 parties, and everybody else who hasn't got a yes, I put down a Green Party candidate with a maybe. And I'm going to plug Kevin here because he's a Bank of Canada supporter and account supporter, and if I weren't here, I'd vote for him. But you gotta vote for me because I'm leading this notorious group. I'm trying to make it go viral. There's a YouTube video that simply says SmartestManOnEarth.ca smart team. And if you go there, I'm asking my friends to simply send this up, letting your friends know I want an interest-free bank account at the Bank of Canada to settle my debts and get out of debt someday. You should too. And if that could go viral, you and your family could have interest-free. deserve the fate you're gonna get. Johnny Engineers, sign it off. Mark has a strategy. Okay, it's not gonna work. You can't come up with enough money to settle with the farmers who are all in debt up to here. But an interest-free Bank of Canada account for farmers would let them compete for the agricultural resources and tractors with the big corporations. And they wouldn't have to sell up to the big corporations with the money if they had their own credit lines, would they? So, give the farmers all interest-free Bank of Canada accounts, or vote for the strategy for your good wishes.
Okay, so now we'll take questions from the floor, and if you could stick to 30 seconds.
I would like to know where the party stand on Canada's involvement in Syria, Iran, Afghanistan, and what those parties will do moving forward as far as our military is concerned.
Okay, I might start with the middle candidate first, and then Kevin, and then Mark.
Well, I don't think we have any reason to have our nose in the Middle East at all. We started shooting at them first, they're going to start shooting back at us now. And then the government's going to go, remember when Pierre Trudeau just needed one grenade in a mailbox to take away our rights? And now they've stirred up the Middle East by bombing them. And now we're going to spend $56 billion on new warplanes to protect us from the polar bears. Don't they know climate is going to get them? $56,000 million on warplanes. While people go hungry. Isn't that lunatic? And not one of the other parliamentary parties has spoken about that huge waste on warplanes. We only need them because we're going overseas to be the invaders and bomb people. You really want all our Canuck kids coming back after being Garth Vaders and committing suicides like in the States? 5,000 dead soldiers, 125,000 suicided soldiers. It's no fun being an invading army. Oh, Canadians, we just dropped bombs. We just got everybody in Libya, didn't lose one guy. What a wonderful little war Libya was. All we had to do was drop bombs and kill thousands and destroy the nicest little country on the planet. Imagine that, he was getting a human rights award from the UN and they made you believe he was bombing his own people and you fell for it. Well, Canada helped kill Africa's saint. This is the guy who gave them satellites, gave them interest-free loans. If only you knew what you'd done. And we're going to pay when the Africans come at us for what we did to Gaddafi. So we're doing the same thing in Syria, where we shouldn't be wasting $56,000 million on warplanes. As invaders, we've got nobody to be defending from, right? That's the reason we shouldn't be spending that money on war. We've got no real enemies. It is shocking that dental isn't part of healthcare. I have friends, poor friends, with rotten teeth, suffering, and I'm shocked. You know that a high-tech country like ours can't count dental with other healthcare, isn't it? But they don't have enough money to fund the healthcare system when they're busy funding war planes and paying debt service in the budget first, right? $56,000 million, then you can maybe get your teeth fixed. In Argentina, when they had no money, the union said, no layoffs, the hospitals. Pay us with small denomination bonds we can use for hydro taxes, medical, and licenses. And we'll stay online. And they did, they got paid, other people took the money. No layoffs, more employment, all federal, all foreign debt paid off in 5 years. Didn't make the news. But the Argentine hospitals stayed open, full employment, funded by provincial bonds, instead of sending a bond to the bank to get bills, and they saved interest. So, you are not going to get your teeth fixed with any of these short-of-cash governments who aren't talking fixing the money system. So if you don't vote for a Bank of Canada account, which would immediately make it affordable to you, well then, like I said earlier, you're going to get what you deserve. Well, my ideals can be expressed in two lines. I want no cops and gambling. I got tired of being busted. Sex. Shy and poor people got a right to get laid. Or drugs. None of our business should be for the doctors or rock and roll. And I want no interest on loans. Pay cash or time, no dole. So I'm a libertarian, so cred. Libertarian personal ideals, and I want sociable credits at the Bank of Canada. Now, friendly credit. Jesus said, lend expecting nothing in return. And he explained the ethos of the lens in Paul Corinthians 2, chapter 8, 14. He said, your abundance should at the present time be a supply for their want, so that their abundance can later be a supply for your want. Which means, lend to him when he's short, so he can lend to you back when you're short. That was how Christian communes worked. So, libertarian social credit is my ethos. And I just want to point out that when Jesus said the kingdom of heaven is at hand, and 50 years later they were laughing at him saying, hey, Roman's still in charge, it wasn't at hand. He didn't mean soon, he meant here. The only difference between heaven and hell is whether your debts grow with interest or not, is what his parable of the talents says. He says the kingdom of heaven is like, then he describes a master who's a loan shark. And then he executes his servant for not paying him his interest, like in today's world, foreclosure. So, let's is complete Christian, Islamic, Jewish ethos. Nehemiah, Jesus, Muhammad all said the same thing. Let the exacting of interest stop. And let's is simply the software that has no interest. You can't get better. And there's my ethos in one package. The purpose of trade agreements is to spread the shortage of money around as fairly as possible. Okay, there's not enough money. All countries borrow from their private banks the principal, use it to produce goods, and all have to inflate their price to recuperate the principal plus the interest. Well, you put $100 billion into circulation paying for the goods, you're charging $110 billion on the store shelves, $10 billion remains unsold, you must export, or the banks foreclose. And all countries are in the same bind. Now, they can't have the Japanese suddenly sell steel at half price by making them fight higher prices at home on the rest of the steel. That's called dumping. And you don't want to have countries selling you stuff for less than the price of production. Well, what's wrong with that? Some guy wants to sell you stuff cheaper than it costs to produce. Why would you object? You gotta be stupider than him, right? And yet we do. We're all fighting. We don't want him dumping his products cheaper than it costs to make to us. We try and stop that. Why? Because we need to sell ours so we can pay more of our debt off and avoid more foreclosure for us. Everybody's trying to avoid failure, foreclosure, and the death gamble mortgage. Every country. And that's what they need trade agreements for, to try and spread the shortage around as fairly as possible. And don't hurt too many people too much in one place. So just spread the victims around fairly. That's what all they do. But the moment people in other countries do have access to their central banks and don't have to pay debt service no more, it's like getting twice the money you ever got before. It's like cutting the cost of living in half, not paying any more interest on production. Well, this is something we definitely disagree on. All the parties believe in global warming. I got bets out there. If anybody want to bet me $100, I say it's colder next year. There's been a pause, they call it, for 18 years. Well, you remember the scandal when they used a trick to hide the decline in temperature since 1998? And then a pause they hid. It was a decline they hid. These are guys with science degrees who lied to us. And I'm a guy specialized in statistics. teaching assistant in a mathematics and gambling course, and a degree in electrical systems engineering, and I know thermometers, and it's getting colder, and I've got no global warming hoaxer to bet me, except for Adriana the Green in Toronto, who ain't paid up yet. I'll bet anybody $100 next year's colder. The year after that's colder. The year after that's colder. Wake up! Look at the snow. It's already here. Ask the farmers. And these parties are such scientifically incompetent, run by the Tory economist and the liberal and the green lawyers. And the liberal, sorry, he's an artsy. The green and the NDP lawyers. And you're going to trust them on a matter of thermometers? I'm Johnny Engineer. I bet it's going to get colder. And if you get sucked into this anymore, well, you didn't do your homework. All you got to do is bet any global warming hoaxer, bet you $100 next year it'll be colder. And when he backs down in public, remember the professor bet $30,000 said no one could disprove climate change? Well, of course climate changes. Who can disprove that? I said, hey, bet you $100 next year's colder. And the professor kidding back down and erased my post. So there's my bet. You people are calm if you believe these parties.